Welcome back to my channel. I am so excited about today's video because we are jumping into the kitchen, grabbing our morning fuel, my very best friend in the morning, the one that helps me get through an entire day of work. I'm talking about coffee, and in today's video we are going to be using coffee to paint an entire piece. And this is the final outcome that I came up with today. I am so happy to be revisiting this old technique. I had used it before and I am super happy to have created a piece that is a little bit more intricate than the ones that I had done before. And before we get started, and if you just want to jump into the process of video, you can just jump into the timestamp that's right over here, jump straight ahead and ignore all of my blabbering, because I'm gonna get started in sharing a couple of tips and tricks in case you want to try out this technique at home. And if you've never done this before, you can kind of take these things into consideration before getting started. So the first thing you want to consider is that painting with coffee is very similar, if not the same, as working with watercolors. I don't have a lot of experience working with watercolors, but it is something that I feel it's very mesmerizing to work with colors, to watch other people paint with watercolors. I love it. And this technique is very similar to that. So when it comes to coffee and adding water to the coffee to create that pigment that'll go into your piece, the more water that you add to the coffee, of course, the less pigmented the paint is gonna be on your canvas. And of course, the less water that you add, the more pigment, the stronger your pigment is going to be. Another thing to consider is, of course, that you're working with something edible, so the texture is going to get a little bit sticky, and of course you're dealing with the smell of coffee, which in moderate amounts is of course very delightful, but if you're smelling it very strongly and very closely through a long period of time, it can get a little bit annoying. But if you don't mind the smell of coffee, then of course this won't be a problem. Another thing that you want to consider when using this technique is, of course, using a lot of layers. So once you get a layer down of your first painting, then you want to wait for that to dry a little bit and then come back to your next layer to add different details. The more layers that you add to your painting, the more detail you can get with your piece. Of course, I understand that this is true with watercolor painting, so again, it's very similar to that. You can add a little bit of paint, then go back with like a hairdryer or fan it out with something, and then go back to your dry piece and add more layers. This is going to give you way more detail than just going straight up with one layer. And of course, with that comes a lot of patience in your piece. You want to be very patient with this. Wait for all those layers to dry. If not, you can smear the previous layer and you're just going to end up with like a puddle of coffee. And of course, we don't want that for our piece. And the last thing that I wanted to touch on, I even have notes, you guys. So the last thing was that I did include a little bit of white paint on my piece, and that was just on this part right over here, because you're gonna see in the video that at first I added the branches and then I went on top with this rose, I think. And I was getting a little bit of not enough opacity that I needed, so I went back in with a little bit of white paint just to erase where you could see the branches through the rose, just to erase that. And of course, again, you're gonna see all of that in the video, and that was just the only part where I added a little bit of white paint to my piece. And yeah, I think that was everything that I wanted to touch on before we begin. Thank you so much for staying with me. I really hope you like this video. You are going to see in the video that I kind of jump back and forth when it comes to painting something and then going to another thing, and that's just because I was kind of unsure in how to go about this technique. I'm not an expert in watercolor painting at all, but I do want to get stronger at that, so I really hope you enjoy this video. If you do, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. That really helps me a lot in knowing what kind of content you guys like. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, share this video with any art lover out there. If at the end you have any questions, you can always drop those in the comment section below. I'll do my very best in helping you out in any way that I can. Thank you so much for staying here. Hope to see you on the next one. Take care and have a great day, guys. Bye.